What's up, everyone? Today we are going to be making the five panel camp hat, and we are going to show you the steps to take in order to make your hat look just like this. And first off, you're going to want to get a pattern, and we offer a pattern down in the description if you'd like to use that one, and we show you how to use that pattern and also what machines to use, how to go about different steps on making your hat just look really professional and ready for sale in a store. All right, this is the pattern we are using. You can download this on our website. It'll be in the description below. It is for a five panel hat, and it comes with sweatbands and everything you need for making a full cap. And make sure when you use this, if you use this pattern, you cut on the inside of the black lines. That is very key when it comes to assembling the hat, because if you go outside of it, it's gonna be, the measurements are not gonna be right, and just that little bit makes a big difference. So keep that in mind for when you're cutting out this pattern if you use it. But other than that, we are gonna go on to the next step of cutting out the fabric. All right, we went ahead and traced out our pattern onto the fabric, and this is a soft twill that we're using, and the bias is kind of going that way. So when it comes to the top panel, you're gonna wanna cut it pretty close to the bias so it just wraps nicely. And this fabric also has a little bit of stretch to it because it's a soft twill, and that comes really nice when assembling a cap. When you get to stiffer fabrics, sometimes the pattern will turn out a little different or almost like smaller. But I mean, you can just test all sorts of fabrics to see what works best for you. We found that this works really good. And again, when you're cutting it out, make sure you cut on the inside of the chalk line, because that will keep the measurement precise, and it'll just end up you having a nicer cap in the end. All right, this is a very key part when it comes to making the cap. We went ahead and put our front panel on interfacing, and this interfacing is used in the production of ball caps. So if you're looking for something like this, you're probably not gonna find it at your local hobby shop. You can go online to capsupplyco.com, which will be in the description, and they have all the supplies you need for making baseball caps and making them look professional, because this definitely will help your cap come out looking more professional. And you can apply this with a heat press or an iron, and it just makes it look really good. But yeah, we're just gonna cut it out then. All right, you're gonna wanna start by sewing the top panels together, right sides together. And when you're sewing, make sure you are putting at 1/4 inch seam allowance, and that will get you the perfect measurements for using this pattern. If you're using a different pattern, then you might wanna look into that. But that's a good thing about this one, is we take that into consideration. So, and we also have our machine set at a lower stitch length. So just a nice tighter stitch, and it would just make for more quality of a hat. And so. Also, one more quick thing, make sure, I mean, you don't have to do this, but we do it and it just makes for a nicer looking hat. Change out your thread color to something that will match your fabric. And we did the same with the bobbin as well. So yeah, just make sure you have something that will be pretty close. If not, it's not that big of a deal. But, and it's always good to practice on like black fabric because that's easier to find. Most, I mean, you'll probably have black thread, so that's always a easier route to take at first. All right, this is another key tip. You don't have to do this, but I like to do this. And you can get sewing machines that have cutters on them, so you don't have to cut this by hand every time. But this is like if you're just making a hat with basic like machines and whatnot, and you're not crazy into high production, but trim along as close as you can to the seam. So in our next step, we are going to be covering this seam and also having a top stitch, and we're using a double stitch sewing machine, double needle, and we have our gauge at 1/4 inch. We find that works really nice for the look of it. It's not too narrow, not too wide. And this right here is about 1/4 inch binder. It's about a little over an inch at the front. For when you're using your tape, and we just have this taped on. It's kind of just set up as a quick setup. If you're actually looking to get into production, you're gonna wanna find a more efficient. You can find ones that are designed specifically for this process, and they're gonna be a little bit pricey, but this is a cheap option to get away with, and it looks really nice. And all you do is you line up your seam in that little, with that fin, and then you kind of just guide it through, and you'll find different techniques to make this process a little bit easier. And trim off the axis, but see, it just makes it look really nice along there, and then covers that seam up really good, so you have the inside and the outside of your cap just looking like it's bought from a store. And that's all very simple. I mean, you're gonna have, if you want to do this, you can do it on a domestic machine. We use industrial machines, but if you use it on a domestic machine, you're gonna get a stitch going across the inside, and that's where we went ahead and got industrial double needle, because that will give you a double stitch on the inside and outside, because you have two bobbins. So that will just give you that nice look. All right, so the next step in sewing the panels, you want to sew the front panel to the top panel and just line up the panel as good as you can. And same for this, you're gonna wanna do 1/4 inch seam allowance and sew that on. And then you're gonna wanna also trim this, the excess fabric, after you get done sewing as well with this panel. And I just did that because I started sewing and this was stretching a little bit more on the top. So I'm just gonna put the stretchy side on the bottom, so it ends up in the end lining up a little bit better, because the feed dogs will pull that stretchier fabric through a little bit nicer than if it's getting just pushed up against the presser foot. Then just trim as close as you can without getting too close, because if you get too close, then it's gonna make the stitch weak. then go back over and do, yeah. All right, so we're back over at the double needle, and this is kind of jumping back and forth process when you're doing this, because it just makes it a lot easier when you're laying in these strips, and you're gonna wanna now go ahead and just sew in that seam, and then you're gonna go back over and sew the other panels on. It's kind of back and forth, but it just makes it easier in the long run. And that's why, because you want to go over, because if you sew these together and you're trying to do tape going across here, it just makes it too messy, and it's easier just doing sewing panels together and then doing your tape and then sewing panels and then doing your tape in an order that just makes sense. All right, so now we are going to put on both the side panels, and this part is a little bit tricky. It's not gonna just lay flat and be an easy sew. You're gonna have to keep moving it as you go to line it up, and that is pretty much all you need to know for this part. Make sure you're still going at 1/4 inch seam allowance, and you might, at some points, you might wanna pull the top a little bit more unless you're working with a walking foot, just so that way, because sometimes it just gets one up, the bottom or top will move a little bit different and it'll throw off kind of the alignment of it. But anyways, yeah, you'll see. Again, trim off that little bit of excess fabric and do the same for the other side. We're not gonna show sewing the other side, it's just the same exact thing as what we just did. So just do that and then trim the other side as well, and yep, we'll show you the next step. All right, another quick thing is too, we already sewed this panel on, but when you sew on the panels, a little tip for sewing them on, if you start sewing from the front, make sure you do that to the other side too. I mean, you don't have to, but it just makes the alignment of everything a little bit more square on the end product. So it might be, sometimes it's a little tricky going from the other way. Like if you start at the front here, you're gonna have to do the same over here. And I mean, you'll get used to it over time, but it just helps out with the alignment of everything in the end. So yeah. All right, again, gonna do the same thing for both of these seams. You wanna cover those, and this is the final back and forth process of this. And pretty much once you get that done, your crown is pretty close to being done and you can start working on the brim. But anyways, we're gonna show you. This is a little bit more tricky going around this curve, but just work with it and you'll eventually get better at it. And yeah, it's definitely the harder of them. And sometimes when you pull the fabric apart, it helps it set in that seam a little bit better. All right, so we went ahead and serged around the bottom and the back opening, and this is to hold the seams in a little bit better and to keep this fabric from unraveling. If you don't have a serger, that's fine. You can just do a zigzag stitch around the whole thing, and that definitely helps do a shorter length zigzag stitch, kind of, well, short length and like wider width. It's about a quarter inch. So if you're using a zigzag, just do a quarter inch width. And this next step is pretty important. If you're looking at trying to make a professional looking hat, you will want to use a size strip. And ours are just above quarter inch size strips. And these are also available at capsupplyco.com. And that will be in the description box below. But this is very key when it comes to adding that final touch and just making the hat look like it's out of a store. And you're gonna wanna put this on the inside of the hat. And we changed out our presser foot just for an edge one, and it just makes it a little easier when you're sewing it on if you're trying to go fast. And the stitch length, you can just up it a little bit. You don't have to have it so short. And then you can go ahead and trim them right up flush with the back opening there. And that's all that step takes. I highly recommend this step because it will make your caps look 1,000 times better. And you can get away, you don't have to buy these strips. It's just a lot easier to, because you get a nice strip and it's perfectly cut. You can try to use anything else and cut your own strips, but it's just another step that over time just gets kind of annoying. And if you just have a bunch of these sitting around, it just makes your production a lot faster. All right, so we are gonna finish our edge with bias tape, and you can finish it different ways. I mean, you can just roll it over and hem it. We like to do it this way because it seals off the entire edge and it just makes for a longer lasting hat. And I just like the look of it too. So we actually changed out the entire part of the machine here. It's really easy to do. But you can get ones that just screw in and they're quicker to attach on. But I just like using this because it's more efficient in the long run. But and and you just want to hold it close. Like when you're going over the thicker areas, just you're gonna want to pull over here. It's just sometimes a little too thick, but as long as you keep it close to that edge and you pull it through at the thicker areas, you should be fine. And so that's what. Threads caught up in there, but anyways, it just seals it off really nice, and then these threads can just be trimmed. Just make. All right, so when it comes to doing the brim, you're gonna wanna cut it out on the bias so it stretches this way, and you don't have to do it this way, but I found it works pretty well doing it this way. You just cut out a big enough piece to fit your brim in there. And then what I do is I trace around all the way around and then go down to the bottoms, because I'm actually gonna sew down there too. And when it comes to sewing this, you just wanna make this close as possible. I actually go in a quarter of an inch and follow on the inside of the line with the presser foot, and that's about a quarter of an inch, a little bit over, I would say, because that chalk line's pretty thick, but this will just, it'll make it fit on there nice and snug to the brim, and you won't have any like overlay, like flappiness to it. And you can actually, if you wanna try going in even more, that's definitely doable based on how stretchy your fabric is and what fabric you're working with. You'll kinda wanna find the balance there, and this part right here is probably one of the harder parts to make look nice on the hat without an automatic stitch sewing machine, that like a visor stitch machine that automatically stitches all this. But anyways, just do short length stitch so that way your machine will go a little bit slower, and just follow as close as you can. And then what I like to do when trimming this part, just trim right on the green line, just on the inside of that green line. Give yourself a little bit of excess fabric there, because it just helps when lining up the brim on the inside. And if you cut it too close, sometimes it looks like there's like a little bump there when you finish it, and it's just easier to do it this way, just giving yourself a little bit extra fabric, and then flip it inside out. And then put your brim in there, and this part right here, it's gonna take some time to get used to doing this. And I know this video, in my old video I put glue in here, but you don't need to do that. That's unnecessary. That you just have to make it the right size to the brim. And then try to align it as good as you can in there. Just push it up flush and make sure those, it's on one side of that seam, and that's the key part about this, just making sure that it's all on one side of that seam, and you can just keep playing with it and to get it nice and smooth looking. But then, other than that, you're gonna go into stitching the visor. All right, this is another little trick that you don't have to do this, but it definitely helps out. Pull the fabric as much as you can this way, and just do a little stretch it over that so your and just do a little tack stitch there. You can go all the way if you want, but just enough so it just holds it while you do the stitches on the top, doing the top stitching. All right, so when it comes to stitching the visor, there's a lot of ways you can do this. We like to use a stitch guide. In this, you can adjust this and keep going out like different increments and just keeping those increments the same. And there's a lot more efficient ways to do this, but if you are using a single stitch sewing machine, you can get away with many different ways. We had this one built for us. You can also use like magnets as guides or anything that will hold the brim so you can just keep going around and then changing the size. So we'll show you how this works. And you definitely want to pull the fabric as you do this. Trim it, and that is your first one. You could stop right there and only do one, and it will look nice, because then if you do another one and you mess that line up, it just might make it not look so good. But we like to just do at least three of them. So we were at about a quarter of an inch there, so we're gonna go about the same, and you can measure it up with that. And if you are looking for something like this, we could probably find one for you. Definitely send us an email asking about a visor guide, because they are hard to find. And we had one built for us, so if you're looking for one like we have it, just let us know. All right, so we're gonna do our second stitch now. And it is a little tricky, because I mean, we are working with a longer stitch length, so it's faster, but as long as you just make sure you're following that, you should be fine. And then again, move the next length, and depending on what you're using, just make sure you're moving the right increments or else it might look weird. Usually do three, so you can do as many as you want. Three just kind of looks nice. I know most baseball hats have a lot more than that, but that's generally because they're using an automatic stitch where you just set your brim in there and the machine comes out and goes back and forth. And you can take that route, which that's the route we're taking in the future here, so just look into that too. All right, so for this part, we're sewing along the inside of the brim, and I highly recommend getting a narrow presser foot so you can get more flush with the brim. So just, you're gonna wanna pull as you go, and shorter stitch length would be better. And then this is where you kind of tighten up everything. All There you go. You see, it just makes the fabric a lot tighter to the brim. And then also another thing I recommend when you're doing stitches on brims, this is a part where you really want to match the fabric to the thread, because if you do have a little bit of errors in there, they're not going to show up as much. And other than that, you're pretty much set on making your brim. Now the next step is attaching this to your crown. All right, now we are attaching the crown to the visor. And for this part, mark your middle with chalk, and you can just mark it like that. That's a pretty easy way to mark it. Definitely measure it afterwards just to get it a precise measurement, because you really want this centered. And then also mark your brim. And if you're using the brims we use, most of them come with a notch back here. So if you already have your fabric on, you can feel where that middle is. And you just mark that with chalk. And place those marks together. And if you are using sizing strips, you put that pretty close up to there, up to the brim, and get this as close as possible to that brim. And I start in the middle and go out, just so that way it's aligned. And if you start over here, sometimes it will get unaligned coming through and it just won't line up. So this is a fail-safe way to just keep it aligned, and you do one half at a time. And you're gonna have to work with it going around. Keep it very close to that edge. And then that's why we didn't trim yet this, because this part, it just makes it a little easier putting it on, because you have all this extra fabric to work with. And then this is a little tricky going this way, but I mean, you get used to it over time, so. All right, and then just start back in the middle again and do the same thing for the other side. And this side might be a little bit trickier because, I mean, depending on which way you're used to sewing stuff, just follow along as close as you can. See if it's aligned. Looks pretty aligned. And don't worry if it's a little bit, if it's not close as you want it to the brim, because after we get done putting the sweatband on, we're gonna do a top stitch there, and that will kind of get a little bit closer to that brim. Okay, so now we are going to attach the sweatband, and this part is definitely very tricky. But you can get a sewing machine like this one with a post bed and a roller presser foot, and it makes it a lot less difficult. You can do this on any sewing machine. Just make sure that when you're stitching it directly to the top like that, your sweatband. And you're gonna want to finish your sweatbands like have clean edges, because you're covering up that edge and you're going all the way around and sewing it directly on. And when you get to there, you are going to keep going and sewing on to that, just like that. I mean, it's definitely tricky to do, and that's why we have this post bed, so we can get in there. And then you come around and you keep sewing right directly on top, and that's gonna give that look. And the reason we have that spacer there too, or that sizer, is so that way we can follow along there too and just make it look clean. So we are gonna sew this on now, and yeah, so you can watch this part. It's definitely a different machine than most of them, but if you need help finding one of these, send us an email. We can definitely help you source one. They're not that hard to find. there. It messed up just a little bit, but we're just gonna go back and try to fix that. And that's the other thing too. Sometimes if you're working with a servo motor, it's gonna be a lot easier because you're gonna be able to control the speed, which we have a clutch motor on this right now. And it just makes it a little bit harder to control the speed, and you'll sometimes push it a little too hard. But anyways, you're gonna have little mess hangups like this, and that's what you're trying to do, is avoid these, because if you can avoid anything like this, your production's gonna be a lot more smooth. All right, so now we are gonna top stitch this front panel. And to do that, we are using a edge stitch or top stitch presser foot. And you're gonna wanna make sure you don't get anything caught up. So push this in as much as you can. And you're gonna kind of, you can feel if you pinch it like that, that's where you're gonna be stitching. And don't worry about like messing the hat up or anything, because this part, it may look like it's messing up, but it actually isn't. So we're just top stitching the front part. So we are gonna just start it off like this and just, this helps keep along that edge. So that's why we're using that. You don't have to use that, but it just looks cleaner in the end. Just keep following that. Make sure your sweatband is still on the inside. Also, another thing is too, depending on what color sweatband you are using, I would recommend switching out your bobbin for, like we're using black, so I switched out the bobbin for black so that it just, blends in with that sweatband at the bottom. And then purple up top. All right, so when you're finishing up this end, there's a few different routes you can take. You can go with a strap back or a snap back. For this video, we are gonna be doing the leather strap back, but if you wanna take this route, it's very simple. All you do, you fold these edges in like that, and then you just roll it over and just sew that in like that, and you do the same for the other side, and then you're done. Your hat is done from that point. You can go in and put vents or whatever you want to do. And that's how you do the snapback. But the leather is a little bit different. Essentially the same thing, but you just have a buckle on one end. So we are going to have our leather piece on this side. So we seal off, we totally seal this side right off to start. So we can do that now. Thank you.
And then you can also go in and trim off the access on the inside, but that's how that looks when it's done, nice and clean. And then for the leather piece, you do the same thing, you fold it over. And if you're using the side strips, you're gonna feel them, that it's a perfect fold over. So you put this strap in the length that you want it. And you just do the same thing. You just sew it right in, get a nice tack in there, because you're gonna want, this gets pulled on a lot, and you're gonna want it in there nice and strong. And then that's pretty much it for sewing. Now the rest is finished up with grommets and that's, and we will show you the steps on how to finish that. So that's next. All right, so now we're attaching this buckle and you're gonna have to punch a little hole through, all the way through the sweatband and everything. We are actually using a rivet. It's actually better to use an eyelet, but we ran out of them, or we don't have them sitting around right now. So we are just subbing that out. It's done the same way though. You just put it through and then get your die for whatever rivet you're using and then just press it in there. And that's pretty much it. And then you can just feed your strap through and you should be good. And these straps are a little bit thicker, but they're very quality, so they feed through really nice. It's just hard to get it started. And right there, you could be done, but what I like to do is add in an oval eyelet, so that way the strap can go right in there and be totally hidden. But if you're going for a look with the open strap, then you are done. All right, so now we're gonna be installing the eyelet for the strap to go into. And for this, I already cut the slit, and you are gonna want to cut the slit a little bit smaller than the eyelet. So you push it through and you kind of just work it around the edges, and you take your end piece and you put it on the other side just like that, so you have it perfectly on there. And there's two little flaps right there that you will gently put this down, and then you want to bend those over the sides, and that's gonna, you can just take a screwdriver and push those over. And you can then from there just trim it up a little bit, and that will be on good though. And this is a way to do it without a die. Obviously it's a lot easier to use a die press, but these dies are a little hard to come by with the right sizing, and you can order them to get punch holes and everything, so you don't have to cut a slit. But other than that, that's how it looks when it's installed. It looks pretty nice, just makes the hat look a little nicer, and it just feeds through there really clean. Okay, so we are going to use vented eyelets for the side panels, and we went ahead and marked where we want those. You can kind of eyeball where you want them, what looks best to you, change it up, do whatever you want with it. But these are very nice to have. You can get these online, these eyelets and die sets, but you pretty much just go in and cut a snip. Or if you have a hole punch too, you can use a hole punch, whatever you prefer. And then you place your eyelet in there, bottom, and that's how it turns out. We're not gonna do all of them because just to save time, but you have a nice eyelet, vented eyelet, and that's what comes on a lot of five panels. So there's an option for you, or you can, if you have a eyelet sewing machine, go ahead and use that, but those are very expensive, and this is just a cheaper alternative. All right, so from here, you are pretty much done. There is one final step that I really recommend, and that is steaming. Like, you're gonna wanna have sort of block like this to put your hat on. And you put it on there, nice and snug, and then steam it. Steam all the way around. Steam that sweatband, steam the top, steam everything, and that will just make the inside look really nice. Cause right now it's kinda like, you know, the inside looks a little bit not so finished, but this part right here will take that to the next level. And if you don't have a steamer like this, you can use an iron steamer, or any sort of steam will work. I even think trying to iron it might work too if you just have an iron. But this will make it look really nice on the inside. And you're gonna wanna let this sit for a little bit after you get done steaming it. And they make machines that do this automatically for caps, but pretty hard to get your hands on. But if you find one, definitely take advantage of it because it just makes the end product look a lot better. Like store-bought, I guess. Which essentially that is your goal if you're trying to manufacture hats. All right, from there, just take it off and look at how much nicer it looks on the inside. And that's due to the steam and just stretching it over a block. And that right there, you're done from there. That is finished and you can wear it, whatever. All right, thanks everyone for watching. We really appreciate it. Be sure to like, subscribe, comment, let us know what you think. If we missed any steps or if you want to see something more in detail, just send us an email or something. And once again, if you're looking for the brims and anything that you need to make this hat and make it look really professional, just go to capsupplyco.com.